So it's my honor to present the final DuPont-Columbia Award of the evening. This is the first time in a decade that the jury has awarded a gold baton, our highest honor. It goes to Frontline PBS, which in my time here, I think it's been up on this stage every one of the last five or more years. And this year, the jury wanted to recognize two important features of Frontline's journalistic achievements. One is the consistent way that Frontline has been a standard bearer for investigative long-form reporting in the very best traditions of broadcast and documentary filmmaking. But equally, the extraordinary ways that the franchise has adapted to the digital era by creating new forms of investigative work in lots of formats, from podcasts to really rich online interactive archives. The jury cited eight programs as representative of Frontline's achievement, and they are Bitter Rivals, Iran and Saudi Arabia, Life on Parole, Living with Murder, Mosul, Myanmar's Killing Fields, Putin's Revenge, The Gang Crackdown, and The Last Generation. And here to accept the gold baton for Frontline PBS is executive producer Rainey Aronson Rapp.
It's a lot of people. Forgive us. It's eight projects, and as you know, it's deeply collaborative work. So I would really love for all of the members of the film teams, the audio teams, and the interactive teams to join me. Thank you so much, Dean Cole. This means the world to me. It's deeply gratifying to be here tonight, honored alongside so many colleagues, supporters, and friends. Thank you to all the members of the jury for this remarkable award. Thank you so much. When I heard the news, it was so meaningful to me. Frontline, honored as a standard bearer and also an innovator, was exactly what we have all been trying to deliver, to produce high-quality investigative journalism across forms, staying true to our documentary roots, but also producing new works from long-form narrative audio to digital interactive filmmaking. On stage and off, there are too many people to name and to thank, but it is a joyous event for us all to be together, out of edit rooms, off the road, celebrating this collective work. Many of our colleagues, you can't believe this, are not with us. I wanted a special shout out to our colleagues in Boston who are still hard at work. There are filmmakers here on the stage with me who have been with the series since its very beginning, and others who have joined our ranks more recently. There are producers and reporters, web designers and digital creators, cinematographers, writers, and editors. Editors, I must say, who always ask the right tough questions, all of whom help make Frontline what it is. And of course, our partners and the journalistic collaborations that have become a mainstay in our work life. We are all unified by the single pursuit of clear-eyed, fair, and tough journalism. Journalism in the public interest, sustained and supported by the public, and now for decades by generous foundations and individuals. We thank you for your trust, especially PBS and the stations, CPB, and our amazing colleagues at GBH as well. Thank you. Without all of you, this would not be possible. For me, this is such an honor, but also a responsibility to continue this tradition and trust built for so many decades by David Fanning, my longtime mentor, our founder and former executive producer. Thank you. The challenge I was given was to find new ways to grow the series and to expand it with the promise of reaching new generations of people who believe in accountability journalism and the public interest. Finally, on a purely personal note, I want to thank my mother and my father, who taught me all about finding meaningful work, but also about the virtues of hard work. My father's in the audience with me tonight. He doesn't like attention like this, but thank you, Dad, for everything. It's such a rare treat to be with him, with all of you, and all of my colleagues at Frontline. Thank you so much. Thank you.